welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Alex and thank you so much for tuning in today's video. If you have not been following my series of Singles Diaries, welcome. Today is part three and I am going to be talking about the difference between guarding your heart versus having too many walls. So I know it's been a minute since I've posted anything related to these series and it's not that I've been putting it off or anything like that. I just wanted to make sure what I was talking about today is something that I was really praying about before I share it with you guys. But I'm just gonna dive right into it today. So first, what is guarding your heart? Guarding your heart is a biblical principle of basically protecting yourself and that closeness with God, even in the midst of possibly meeting people and meeting someone that you're probably maybe gonna date. It's just good to guard your heart in those moments. I'm gonna read Proverbs 4:23. NIV version 2, guys, and this is a verse where God speaks about guarding your heart. Above all else, guard your heart, for everything you do flows from it. The first thing I think of when I read this verse is it opens the door for a more of an intimacy with God because you're obeying Him, and even when it's hard to do this. I know from my personal experience, guarding your heart does not come easy. It's something you have to think about every single day. It's something you have to choose daily because it's not easy. Our flesh wants to pass the boundary sometimes, and so it's good to set boundaries, especially when you're thinking about dating somebody. I've set a couple boundaries for myself, and anyone who knows me knows that I can be up until like 3-4 o'clock in the morning. I've just always been this way. So two boundaries I set for myself are if I'm talking to a guy on the phone or texting someone, I have to end that conversation by a certain time. And if I'm out and about on a date or something, there's also a certain time I have to be home. No one told me to create these curfews or boundaries. This is just something that the Lord put on my heart to set for myself. And a lot of it because I know that it opens the door to mess up. Everybody's gonna have different boundaries set for them in order to guard their heart. And this is not the only way to guard your heart. There's many other ways. And so, I just wanted to share a couple of mine with you guys so you just kind of hear a couple of examples of what that looks like. So now that we've talked about what guarding your heart looks like, what does building walls look like and how does that affect, or how can that affect your future relationship? Building walls are built from past negative experiences, and there are things that typically will carry on throughout your life, and it's very easy to start comparing people to past hurt where you just end up building walls because you're triggered by something that somebody didn't even do. It's very easy to start comparing people to your past mistakes. I know for myself, I would be triggered by the smallest things. Someone can say a certain thing and I would become easily offended by that. So therefore, I would just immediately just put up a wall. Being self-aware of the fact that I easily build walls up to protect myself and knowing the damage that could cause on not only the relationships and friendships I have in my life right now, but how that can greatly negatively impact my future relationship with whoever that could be. It's really not too long ago I thought building walls was a good thing because it protected yourself. It was a protected mechanism that protected you from getting hurt again. And so in my past experience, I've been hurt a lot. So I thought it was a good thing to build walls. I thought if anything, it kept you close to God by protecting yourself from other people. Not only does it keep the bad out of your life, but it keeps the good out of your life as well. A perfect example for this is with myself is a couple years ago when I first found the church I attend right now is I literally put an entire wall that separated me from the church. And what this looked like was I would attend church every Sunday, but I would purposely arrive about 10 minutes late and I would leave the church about 10, 15 minutes early as well. And the reason why is because I knew if I arrived to church late, nobody would stop to talk to me. And I knew if I left a little early, people would also not talk to me because they're still in service or they know I'm leaving early to do something else. So point is, I protected myself from the good people that were wanting to pour into my life. During this time as well, I also struggled greatly with hearing God. I was in prayer, I read the Bible, I was reading my devotions, I did everything I thought I was supposed to do, but I did not know why I could not hear God. Later after that, I did eventually get involved in my church. I started learning to serve at my church. Therefore, I was learning to communicate and connect with new people. Once I learned to break the walls down a bit, I learned it wasn't as scary as I thought it was gonna be. Building all of these walls that were supposed to protect me from people actually kept me away from finding a partner because I was too afraid to let anyone get to know who I was. I was okay with knowing who people were, but when it came to the time for them to know who I was, I just was not comfortable with putting myself in such a vulnerable position that required me to open up about myself. When I would start to feel something for somebody, I immediately would freak out and I would immediately have those walls that just took so much time to break down and just build them right back up because I did not like the feeling of being vulnerable or allowing someone to get to know who I was because I felt that it was opening the door to allow myself to get hurt again. I know how scary that could be. And once they learned how to set healthy boundaries and understand what triggered me and learn how to deal with these things in a healthier manner, and I'm still learning this today, knowing that God is right there protecting me regardless of what I go through, it gives me such peace in knowing that I'm never alone in whatever it is I go through. So what I've learned is being single is so fun. We got triggers, we got walls, we got past her. Isn't it just so fun being single? So yeah, guys, be single. It's so fun. The ultimate goal of this video is to bring encouragement to you guys and to let you know it's okay to be honest with yourself, even if it's not easy. And sometimes it's hard. It typically means you have to continue to work on yourself. But at the end of the day, we all need work because we're not perfect. God did not build us to be perfect. So make sure you show yourself some grace as well. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. It really means a lot to me that you just take the time to watch this. And don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up if you enjoyed it. And don't forget to subscribe and click the bell notification. And I will see you guys in the next video.